welcome back to my channel. Thank you for tuning back in. Happy New Year! About half a month has already passed. So for those of you that are unaware, I think in the past one or two videos ago, I kind of insinuated that I'll be traveling to Bali at the end of 2022, and that is exactly what happened. So I traveled to Bali on the last week of 2022 and the first week of this year. So I decided to make a travel series similar to the one I did when I went to Canada. This will be a three-part series called I BALIve. So just to get some admin matters in before we actually delve into the video, for all of our planned activities and tours that we did, that we had a driver with us to take us around, we booked everything through klook.com.sg. I will insert all of the links that we took or we booked in the description box, and it will give you some clarity on how we decided to plan our trip. Klook is this site where you can book a lot of things related to travel as well as attractions, and this is no sponsorship from Klook. I am not paid by anyone to talk about this, but I personally use Klook, so I'm just sharing my experience on how it went. So there's a few things we booked on Klook. Number one was this thing called a Klook Bali Pass. So based on that pass, you can kind of save activities if you were to book it in bulk instead of booking them separately. So we booked two standard activities as well as two super saver activities. So we are at Canggu Airport right now. Everybody say hey! 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 Yanni, hello! So my bags were originally 7.7 kg and now it is the lucky number 7. Yay! What happened? What are you carrying?
Your baggage.
Yeah, because I told her to.
You're leaving your baggage with me.
Yeah. My what kind of baggage? Emotional baggage. Let's go explore the transit area. Friends, we're gonna be meeting in Ubud.
Oh look, monkey!
Monkey!
You cost more than my entire degree.
Same. And my entire fortune at the current given moment. Very nice to meet you, Mr. Bones. Are you happy to meet me? Silent expression as always. I appreciate your kindness.
He smiled.
My friend says that I'm biased to any word with cha in it. This is one more. Bacha. Mocha and matcha. So we're currently in the terminal for transit.
2, 1.
Looking for your bubble tea? We have some koi here. We have like a nice display for Christmas. Like a little palace structure almost. That is where we ran from. Okay, so let me explain what has happened until now. Our flight to Bali was supposed to take off at 9:05 p.m. but something happened and the flight retimed to about 10:40. It's currently... It's 9:45, we have about an hour until we need to board. By the time we land, it's about 12:30. By the time we get to the hotel, it is 1:32, even more than that. So for someone that has never flown from T4 before, this is kind of the view. This is the transit area.
That's so cool. It's like electronic games.
Kind of. There's an international food hall, which just translates to a very fancy kopitiam. There's also a snooze hall for people to... No, snooze lounge for people to take a nap before they board their flight. They have a specific lounge for this particular airline. Why are you so special? And they have 24-hour food. Chair looks highly suspicious. Actually, that does feel kind of nice. Free massage. You look like you're humping the chair from the back.
Hey,
Now, what we need to do is that we need to walk straight to immigration. All of like the scriptures and like whatever is up here is so cute. Oh my god, look at these like puppet figurine things.
Puppet figurines.
Look! It's like that stick puppet show thing that they do. So, we just escaped the VOA crowd.
Thanks to
the Singapore passport. We... Thank you, Red Passport. I love you.
You're not the only way.
Okay, this is kind of walking footage. Wonky footage.
Wonky.
But because we didn't have any carry-on luggage, we have successfully made it past everything. We're now looking for the exit. We don't really know where that is. We are the first people out. We are literally the first people out. Congratulations! Yay!
Take a photo.
This is the Negara Rai International Airport. Yeah, we made it. And we are on the road. Good morning. Morning, Bali. So it is 12:07 p.m. We kind of woke up really late because we went to sleep after 4 a.m. because we only got to our hotel after 3 a.m. Needless to say, our accommodation situation right now.
Each room has four little bed situations, and it's like a bunk, two bunk beds basically.
With a few other people. I'm talking a little softly because I don't want to wake anyone else up.
Toilet is shared, the water dispenser is shared, the tables and aircon, everything is shared. The toilet was extremely dirty. It just shows that the owners didn't really bother to clean it. So it's kind of like an accommodation that you stay for a night or two, only if you want to like dump your bags and go and sleep. But other than that, it's not really worth to stay there and really like spend your time in the accommodation because it is not made for that purpose. It's somewhere for you to crash for the night. As for transport, Bali does have some kind of a public transport system, but it is not very friendly towards foreigners because you need to get like the card, you need to top it up, it can only be done in certain places, and you can only get on certain stops, and it's only operate in certain areas. Basically, kind of inconvenient. The buses are very big and the roads can sometimes be small, so traffic and getting stuck on the road is a high possibility. And for foreigners like us that don't really have time to spend on things like this, we decided to not use the public transport system at all. We instead stuck to private transport. We booked through apps such as Grab and Gojek. So we've got ourselves our breakfast / lunch. So what are you trying?
It is the Atlantic. So there's smoked salmon, there's egg, and there's sour cream.
Okay. Is it good?
Taste-wise, it is Atlantic salmon.
That's good. I've been waiting to have coffee since yesterday. Let's get a tomato. It's like a tomato. So we just finished lunch and we'll walk along the road to go to the beach.
in the direction of the
beach. Yeah.
We're walking to where we can smell the water. Shall we cross?
Look at the speed they are coming in.
Let's cross. And something in Bali is that everyone honks at each other and we still don't know who is honking at who. And who wants to go where. Yeah, I feel like the roads here, no one writes any signs. The signs are present for Google Maps, but not anywhere else. Okay, so I feel like the perfect way to describe the streets of Bali is that it's just littered with stuff. Is that you would see an apartment, then you would see a shop, and then you would suddenly see a rice field. And it's just like that throughout. I'm wearing a hat because it's quite sunny. By a little market, because it looks very interesting.
Yeah, same.
Rice terrace. Beach number one of several. So it is, I love the little streak of clouds all the way very straight. Sun looks nice and bright, but it's not hitting sun, it is tobled sun. There are people sunbathing and you can see a lot of surfers out in the edge over there. We plan to go down there with our shoes off and just walk. Take a little romantic walk by the beach. Escape, escape, escape! It's very interesting geography because the beach is here, but we have a little ponding sitch going on here. The water is so clear. Hello! It's a horse in the sea. It must be like this a little cage of to stand by the beach. Close your eyes, breathe it in. It's almost like a second bank that has formed because all of the backwash has seemed to come in and form another river of sorts. Look at this, it's unlike anything I've ever seen before. Area, and as you can tell, it's pretty bustling. This is supposed to be the most city-ish, very bustling kind of places of Bali. Other places in Bali are not like this, so this is the last time we're experiencing so much humble and jumble. Yeah. We found this place called Kopi Toko, and it's like this cute little cafe that's a minute walking distance from our hostel. The best decor of a cafe that we have seen so far. So one thing I've realized is that a lot of cafes or places, basically wherever that we've been to, the table always has either a jar of brown sugar, or they serve you brown sugar or sugar water if it's drinks. And I think it's because Indonesians seem to have a liking towards sweet. Maybe because the foods that they've grown up eating are kind of sweeter. So good afternoon, we are at accommodation number 2 of our Bali trip. Here is our room. The whole upkeep of this place is really homey, it's really interesting. There's like another floor up, I believe it's for more rooms up there. But let me show you the downstairs area, it's really pretty. So when you come down from these stairs, you have like a little garden sitch.
It's actually quite nice. And this is the entrance. Maybe we'll be okay. I know that you're coming back home.
In our package together with the Katak Fire Dance was the GWK Cultural Park, which stands for Garuda Vishnu Kansana Cultural Visitor Park. I don't know whether we went at the wrong time, we went pretty late in the evening, or whether we went when the park was not completely complete. Based on reviews, I heard it was about 65-70% complete. I didn't really get to see much there. It was just like some kind of prayer thing was going on.
Cara bersama-sama agar kita semua sama hidup dan sama-sama.
I have very limited knowledge of Bahasa. The only words I know is pintu keluar and nasi campur. Amongst a few other very basic distinct words. But we couldn't really make head or tail of what was going on. We just went, looked around, saw the landscape and left pretty much 30 minutes after we got there. It was an interesting sight, and I feel like we would have had a better kick out of it if we had gone in the day, but we went in the evening, so there was mostly nothing much going on and it was just locals there, and we were like the only few foreigners. So yeah. So now let me talk more about the accommodations we stayed at. We decided to budget a little bit on our accommodations and stay in homestays / hostels instead of booking the traditional resorts. I think it's just one, because we wanted to save money, one. And number two, I think we wanted to have a different experience. At least for me, my intention was to try something that not every single foreigner would try. It's so easy to book a resort and to pay the extra money and have the security of everything being taken care of and everything being provided for, but I wanted to try the other route to see whether that is also an economical option and whether it is a viable option for tourists coming to Bali for the first time. And as I learned, it is kind of a hit or miss, because some of our accommodations were better than others, far better than others, and some were okay, to say the least. They deserve their ratings. Well, that is the end of the first part of this three-part series. As you can see, I already kind of have my thoughts about Bali in general, and we'll have to see in upcoming parts on whether those thoughts stay or not. And this is just the beginning. This was just a mini introduction into our trip in Bali. We still have a lot of activities for you to see through my eyes and for you to enjoy. So I hope you've had fun watching this video, and please stay tuned to the other parts. I will see you in the next one. Bye!